and also give them an opportunity at an offensive rebound.
Said and done, 10 Toros made that final roster cut. One of those, Lewis Clinch, coming off the bench this evening, the Georgia Tech guard, 14 points, the game's high score, leading the way for the Toros. Right now, at halftime, they lead 50-45. When we come back, we'll send you back courtside to rejoin Mark Koenig and Malik Rose for the live call of second half action.
The two-point game, 50-48. Curtis Gerald with a bounce pass to Dwayne Jones, backing down the NBA-assigned Byron Mullins. Right back out to Curtis Gerald, looking for the cutter. Instead, shoots from 20. No good, but a whistle and a foul. The five out there for the Toros, the same five who started the game. Curtis Gerald, Russell Carter, Dwayne Jones, and Alonzo G. We get them all there, Bowen, Jones, Gerald, Carter, and G. And then for the Tulsa 66ers, Devon Harden, Larry Owens, Moses Ihambe, Byron Mullins, and Mustafa Shakur. Shakur with 9 points in that first half, including a three-pointer. Toros in the opening half shot 49%. And the 66ers, 53%. Toros were 4 of 9 at the three-point line, while the 66ers were 3 of 5. At the free-throw line, Toros 6 of 7, and the 66ers were 4 of 5. Free throw, no good for Gerald. He missed them both.
Yeah, he's doing his Jekyll and Hyde impression. He's 12 of 12 opening night. Misses two right there.
Backing down his man as Owens flips it up. No good. Good defense by Alonzo G, and he'll run it up himself. Changing hands on the dribble. Toros by two. 60 seconds gone by. Lost it, and it is scooped up by Tulsa. Owens with a bounce pass to Shakur, who nearly got clotheslined by Justin Bowen, and he'll go to the free throw line.
That's a veteran foul by Justin Bowen. He had a hard foul in the first half. Definitely didn't want Shakur to get the easy layup right there, getting his money's worth out of his fouls. I love it.
Toros with ten assists and 8 turnovers in the first half, so that's a positive ratio.
Yep.
Tulsa, 6 assists and 9 turnovers. Free throw good for Shakur.
Good ball game here, both ways. Both teams playing hard. This is the kind of game, if you're a basketball fan, you want to be a part of. You want to witness this.
Last foul on Justin Bowen was his second free throw. Shakur is good. The point guard out of U of A. That doesn't seem like it was a tough decision to go from Philly to Tucson. You know, when you walk out there, see the palm trees as Gerald knifes in, scores, and draws the foul.
Great move by Curtis Gerald. Now everybody just waiting to see him get up. He took a hard foul on the great finish. Again, going to the basket, finishing with the right hand, Curtis Gerald.
A lot of guys going down hard tonight.
It's a physical game, I just said, you know, alluded to. Well, he finished with his left hand, as shown by the replay here. But the guys are playing hard on both teams. I'm really, you know, enjoying this ball game. It's very easy to call. Guys playing with a lot of heart and determination, trying to get better. Definitely trying to get that call up to the next level.
Pretty good tempo both ways. Exactly. Free throw for Gerald. This time it's good. And Gerald gets the three-point play the old-fashioned way. So Shakur against Curtis Gerald gives to Mullins, right back to Shakur, to his left with 12 on the shot clock, drives against Bowen, sets up Owens in the corner. He'll shoot from 14. It's no good in the rebound. Dwayne Jones for the Austin Toros. So Jones, 11 points and 5 rebounds. Carter knifes inside and lays it in. First basket of the game for Russell Carter, the assist to Justin Bowen.
That's exactly what we talked about earlier in the broadcast with the assist. Toro's really sharing the ball, great interior passing, and it's resulting in some really high percentage layups.
Shakur to Ihambe off a screen, fires no good, but a foul on Russell Carter.
Yeah, kind of a silly foul there by Russell Carter. He was late, trailing Ihambe off the down screen, ran into him with the body after Ihambe was already up into a shot.
So you've seen 4 D-League games now,
yep.
And you've seen 3 teams, because you've seen the Vipers twice and the 66ers twice.
Mm-hmm.
Of all the teams that you've seen, who's the most impressive player you've seen so far?
Most impressive player I've seen so far, it's probably a toss-up between 2 or 3 players. Definitely Alonzo G for the Toros. I've seen him the most, but I really like what Mike Harris brought to the game in game two against the Vipers the other night. And Joey Dorsey in that second game really imposed his will inside.
Second free throw for Ihambe is good, so he splits the pair. But the difference between a guy in the regular rotation in the NBA and a guy who's back and forth between the D-League and the NBA is Joey Dorsey doing it night in and night out, because the first game he didn't play like that.
Not at all. I don't know if he had jet lag flying from Houston in here to Austin.
It's
but
a one-hour flight, man. It's a one-hour flight from the Valley. We can't blame it on that.
Hey, jet lag is vicious in the Central Time Zone. But he really, you know, was a different player the second night. Really just imposed his will, controlled the paint. He and Mike Harris had a great game. But, you know, for the Toros, I really like what Alonzo G brings to the game night in and night out. And also Curtis Gerald. I love his pace and his point guard play. I really want to see him improve on his shot, and then he could be gone also.
There's G cutting hard to the basket and draws a strong foul by Devon Harden, his fourth.
And one of the few times Alonzo G saw a little bit of daylight to the basket. He went hard. He wasn't going to be denied that time. He was either going to flush it or get to the foul line where he is right now.
Yeah, let me correct myself. That was on Mullins and not on Harden. Harden got a free shot after the foul on Mullins. What's the deal on that? You know, if you hear the whistle, you just go and try to, you know, give the guy a forearm? I mean, how's that work?
Man, I don't know. You know, these guys, I guess they're in training for the NBA. In the NBA, you have a lot of what I call almost fights. You know, a lot of guys getting in everybody's faces, but nobody's really going to throw a punch. I say 95% of the time it's just a lot of mouthing. And that's really, you know, it kind of is after a lot of the cheap shot stuff that we just saw right there.
Alonzo G with a pair of free throws. Toros by 6, 57-51. But they know that all the games are on TV, so you got to look tough out there, right? I
mean, and especially, oh!
Oh, Harden misses the dunk off the feed from Shakur. And the rebound to the Toros. Gerald's in transition. Cut off on the baseline. Picks up his dribble. Bounce pass out to Justin Bowen. Hesitation move goes up. His shot rejected. Goes to Gerald's. Clinch plus the three. Kicks right, and Justin Bowen slipped. A lot of action out there, no points.
Lots of action. I think Harden was up a little bit too high on that dunk. He went for the flush and hit the front rim, got hung on his own dunk, but then he came back and kind of atoned for it with a big block on Justin Bowen going down the middle for the slam.
Ihambe to Mullins, back to the basket against the shorter Bowen, cross court to Owens. Here's Shakur, head fake, right elbow jumper. No good, follow dunk attempt, missed again by Harden. And another offensive rebound at Shakur. Left baseline, he lost his footing, and a steal by the Toros. Gerald with a lead to G, who runs right into the defender, and a blocking foul called on Larry Owens.
Great call by the referee. Larry Owens was back there waiting, but he got caught in the charge circles. You see here on the replay, Lonzo G extending to the basket, the Lone Star replay. But you couldn't see the charge circle, but it was an accurate call by the referee, Scott Twardsky.
Yeah. Alonzo G going to the free throw line. That was number two on Owens, but I'm surprised we haven't seen any ball boys out there, because we've seen a lot of guys hit the floor in the third quarter, and there's got to be a lot of perspiration. We just saw somebody slip at the other end.
Yeah, well, the ball boys down here in the D-League are a little bit younger, and as we know, it's a school night, so.
And the investment in the players, you know, isn't quite as much as it is on the NBA
league. Oh, the NBA has a lot invested in some of these guys.
So are you surprised that they allow, you know, 10-year-old ball boys out there with all the money invested in some of these players in the NBA?
Hey, it's one way to, I guess, stay in touch with the fans. I love it. I love having the young guys out there, young fans, you know, dreaming of being basketball players.
All right, timeout on the floor. Toros 58, 66ers 51. 8:36 left to play in the third, and D-League basketball continues in a moment. Toros by 7, 58-51. Next broadcast, we invite you to join us on December 8th at 11 a.m., a rare matinee. In the Austin Convention Center on Lone Star Sports Network, ESPN Austin, and NBA Futurecast. Toros take on the Rio Grande Valley Vipers again. Mullins is stripped by the Toros, and the loose ball scooped up by the Toros. So that is December 8th. Rare Tuesday game, Malik. You have to get up here early, man, coming up from San Antonio, 11 a.m. You game for that?
I'm up for it. I have a daughter now. She wakes the whole house up pretty early, so I'll be here.
I feel your pain, man. I have two of them. Mullins called for the frustration foul again. So Mullins with four personal fouls. Maybe one was legit. The other three were frustration.
Yeah, well, I mean, if I'm a coach, I can kind of deal with those because at least he's giving me some energy and some fire and fight tonight. You know, last night if he'd have got these fouls, I probably, you know, would have benched him. But he's playing much, much better tonight. It's not really showing up in the scoreboard, but you can just see him. He has a different pulse, different pace tonight, and I can live with that from a 19-year-old 7-footer, as long as he's getting better.
Size makes up for a lot of mistakes, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Dwayne Jones good on the pair. Toros have their largest lead of the game at 9, 60-51. 4 minutes played here in the third quarter. Ihambe stepped on the sideline right in front of Quinn Snyder, and Tulsa turns it over for the 12th time tonight.
Yeah, Ben Taylor right on top of that call. It was actually a good play. Had Ihambe, a good shooter, coming off a pair of staggered screens on the baseline. He was open for the shot, just stepped out of bounds.
Curtis Gerald's the left-handed dribble, outside right. Shot clock at 12 seconds, plenty of time. Toros lead it by 9, off a screen. It's Clinch, head fake, spins to his left, shoots from long range, no good. And the rebound, Mullins, the big man on assignment from the OKC Thunder with another rebound. He's got 7 rebounds to go with 10 points. Owens for 3, no good for the 66ers. Saved by Mullins, but right to Alonzo G. And he's 1-on-3. He doesn't care. Straight to the rack, shot blocked, but it goes to Bowen, and the Toros retain possession. They'll set it up now and work for a good shot. 12 to shoot. Toros 60. 66ers 51. Gerald spins, fades, shoots. No good over Shakur. And the rebound taken by the 66ers. It's Larry Owens up the right side of the floor. Bounce pass to Mullins. Turns and dumps it down low to Larry Owens. Blocked by the Toros' Alonzo G. Shakur throws the alley-oop. And it is intercepted by the Toros. If they looked up, they had Justin Bowen the length of the floor. But G scoops it up. Now G's starting to get stuff done outside of the scoring column.
Right. He's doing things to help his team win. He knows that he's getting double-teamed and taken out of the game on the offensive end. And he'll find a way around that. But right now he's blocking shots as he shoots an open 19-footer.
And knocks it down.
Knocks it down. But he's going to find a way to help his team win, be it on the offensive, the defensive end, and, you know, hustle and transition, whatever. That's what the scouts are looking for.
Toros with their largest lead of the game at 11, 62-51, trying to beat the 66ers for the second time in as many nights. Left wing Owens lobs from Mullins, deep in the left corner, guarded by Justin Bowen, throws a cross-court Ihambe, catch and shoot three. It's good. It's his spot.
Man, that's a heck of a pass by Byron Mullins. He was 16 feet away from the basket on the left-hand side and flipped it all the way across on the numbers to Moses Ihambe for a good three-point shot.
The lead is 8 for the Toros. Gerald gets a high screen from Jones, trapped near midcourt, and calls the timeout.
Good defense by Mustafa Shakur and Byron Mullins, trapping Curtis Gerald on the sideline.
It is a full timeout. We'll step aside. Toros 62 and the 66ers 54 in NBA Development League basketball.